個咩嘛？嗰個邊個邊個 show 嘅？嗰啲書賣 show 嘅。佢應該喺呢個位喎，啱啱？喺呢個位。
喺呢度。
咁另外攝影師都留意，阿謝 Sir 一陣會有少少嘢會展示嘅，咁啊，佢會坐喺度展示，咁啊，邊個一陣睇啊？咁啊，留意下佢會 show 一個圓筒嘅物體，大家都。冇位坐，
呢度仲
有一張。
差不多了。 好，歡迎大家嚟到今日警方嘅記者會啦。咁啊，首先我會介紹下台上嘅七位講者嘅。咁啊，首先第一位正中間，咁啊就係我哋警察公共關係科總警司謝振中先生。咁而家謝 Sir 嘅右手邊，咁就係消防處副消防總長總部陳慶勇先生。咁而喺陳 Sir 嘅右手邊，咁就係有組織罪案及三合會調查科高級警司李桂華先生。咁翻到嚟呢邊，謝 Sir 嘅左手邊咧，咁就係有我哋警察公共關係科高級警司江永祥先生。咁而江 Sir 嘅左手邊咧，咁就係中區警區助理指揮官酷行動，咁就係廖家琪先生。咁喺阿廖 Sir 嘅左手邊咧，咁就係灣仔分區指揮官周紅女士。咁而最後一位咧，就喺大家嘅最左方，咁就係行動部警司方志堅先生。咁稍後咧，稍後幾位講者會先後發言嘅。咁跟住就會有個問題時間。咁啊，想發問嘅傳媒代表咧，麻煩舉舉手，講出你哋嘅傳媒機構代表邊個傳媒機構嘅。咁啊，最多問三條。咁啊，完咗之後將個麥俾翻我哋同事。咁啊，事不宜遲啦，我時間交俾阿謝 Sir。
好，各位大家好。今日記者會咧，我會先交代一下過去週末一啲公眾活動嘅情況。之後我會交俾江 Sir 作出一啲澄清，同埋講講一啲行動有關嘅數字。今日亦都請到消防處嘅陳 Sir 會講解一下過去一個週末同一啲縱火同埋嚟緊嘅一啲關於縱火風險嘅情況。然後我會交俾中區廖 Sir 會同大家講一講聽日一啲公眾活動發出反對通知書嘅一啲理據。咁之後會交俾灣仔區嘅 Madam Chow 咧，就會同大家講一講咧，聽日關於一啲升旗禮嘅安排。咁最後我會做一個總結嘅。喺開始交代週末情況之前咧，我想先講一講警方就10月1日收到一啲核心暴徒嘅情報。我哋分析聽日嘅情況將會非常非常之危險。警方嘅調查、搜證、情報搜集同拘捕嘅工作咧，係持續咁樣進行嘅。過去3個月暴力嘅升級，過去剛剛週末嘅暴力行徑，同埋一啲情報嘅收集，都顯示暴力嘅趨勢有機會再次上升。核心暴徒行動升級，佢哋暴力影響嘅深度同埋廣度，同埋佢哋嘅計劃。可以話係同恐怖主義嘅行為越行越近。綜合我哋收集嘅同埋一啲網上面嘅情報等等，都顯示有核心暴徒正策劃喺聽日，即係10月1日，將會執行唔同類型嘅襲擊。例如，請大家可以睇睇旁邊嘅大電視。我哋睇到第一張相係關於網上呼籲殺警，要做針對人嘅一啲嚴重暴力，謀殺警務人員或者假扮警務人員殺人。第二張相係要喺商場放火，暴徒要對財產造成嚴重嘅傷害，佢哋聲稱要喺商場、港鐵站掟汽油彈。在油站縱火。第三張相是招募死士，有人在網上無恥到招募有自殺傾向的人去計劃和實行一些造成重大傷亡的事件。這些情報令人非常之擔憂，警方不希望這些情報會變成現實，但我們已經做好一切可以做的準備，有信心、有能力去處理任何的事件。不過我要強調，現時本港受到恐怖襲擊的威脅程度仍然維持在中度的水平。警方分析情報之後作出了個評估，是聽日很大機會出現非常暴力的襲擊事件。警方呼籲市民避免前往有衝突、有暴力事件發生的地點。我們更加呼籲市民不要參與聽日任何違法或者非法的公眾活動，即使一般市民外出都要小心，同意一些形勢有機會最新的發展。警方建議市民如果遇到一些非常暴力的事件，應該盡快遠離現場或者躲藏在一些安全的地方。 然後向警方報案。千祈唔好為咗影相或者拍片而將自己置身於一啲危險嘅地方。跟住落嚟，我會交代一啲關於過去週末嘅一啲情況。喺上星期五嘅記者會，我哋講過希望致力協助市民進行和平嘅公眾活動，但係我哋再一次見到市民生命財產受到暴徒同埋佢哋嘅暴力行為威脅。喺星期六，有示威者不斷衝擊警方喺政府總部近海富中心天橋出入口嘅防線，亦有人用雷射槍襲擊現場警務人員。而家請大家睇一睇電視，留意一下呢張相，有人用雷射槍射向喺半空嘅直升機。下一張，有暴徒用硬物掟爛政府總部外牆嘅玻璃。再下一張，我哋睇到有暴徒縱火掟汽油彈。最後一張，我哋見到暴徒縱火，火舌升到去幾米咁高。到星期日，暴徒喺港島多處縱火，掟汽油彈，將雜物點火，而呢啲火種由金鐘一路蔓延到灣仔、銅鑼灣。上星期五嘅記者會，我哋亦都講過，我哋有責任確保公共安全、公共秩序同埋保障其他人嘅權利同自由。我哋嘅同事喺工作中亦不斷受到襲擊。大家可以睇下呢個盾牌。OK， 这边啊。在星期六，有暴徒用弹叉和砖头在下角度不断襲击我们的同事。我们同事用来保护自己的盾牌，即是大家刚才见到的盾牌，都被打烂了。这个同事亦都被跟着的硬物打伤。大家可以想象，连盾牌都可以打烂，如果当刻是打落我们同事的身上，一定会造成很严重的伤害。在刚过去周末的情况，警方竭力制止暴力的行径，拘捕违法滋事的分子。在这里我想给大家看一看今个周末在公众活动一些纵火的情况。呢啲紅紅嘅火海由金鐘道一路伸延到軒尼斯道、皇后大道東、菲林明道、禮頓道。 有汽油弹咧烧着杂物，啲浓烟升上半空，影响附近嘅居民。呢啲暴徒除咗不断袭击警察，我哋都见到喺金钟道有暴徒眼见前面有警员制服咗被捕人喺地上面，都要向被捕人嘅方向砸汽油弹，佢根本唔理任何人嘅生死。我哋见到暴徒不顾市民嘅安危，佢哋嘅汽油弹甚至掟咗喺一啲民居附近。有暴徒喺菲林明道同警方对峙期间，将汽油弹砸咗喺隔篱店铺嘅门口外面。我哋甚至见到有暴徒攞住一个石油气罐喺处处火种嘅闹市里面游走。我想强调，石油气罐如果爆炸，可以造成好大嘅伤亡。等一阵，消防处嘅陈 Sir 会再同大家讲解。喺过去嘅周末，暴徒一共掟咗接近100枚嘅汽油弹。汽油弹嘅数目之多，警方亦都多次强调，纵火或者汽油弹系可以伤人，亦都可以判处终身嘅监禁。除了縱火，又有暴徒在鬧市打持不同意見的人士，又有人走入商場大肆破壞，大家可以看看電視。为影响的不单止只是政府，不单是维持治安、回复社会是、社会秩序的警员，亦有人因为不同的意见被他们殴打。有人更加在刚才在个片段里面看到在自己的仔面前被围殴，亦都有的士司机被指涉及酿成交通意外，他的的士呢被暴徒数次损坏，包括打爛佢嘅窗嘅玻璃。喺有一城，我哋都有見到有超過20名穿黑衫嘅人士打爛商店裏面唔同嘅設施。警方重申，就任何違法嘅行為，警方必定嚴肅跟進調查。對違法嘅人，我哋定必會全力拘捕。接住落嚟，我會將時間交俾江 Sir 講解一下一啲關於行動上嘅數字。
唔該，謝 Sir。咁首先我會講一講喺過去呢個週末嘅拘捕數字。咁喺9月27號星期五，警方係冇拘捕到任何人嘅。咁喺星期六9月28號，警方喺天水圍、灣仔、屯門、紅磡同埋深水埗總共拘捕咗11人，包括8男3女，年齡介乎16至63歲。拘捕嘅罪名包括刑事毀壞、藏有工具可作非法用途和普通襲擊等等。而在昨日9月29日星期日，警方在港島各區、旺角和天水圍一共拘捕了146名人士，包括118名男子和28名女子，年齡介乎12至53歲。拘捕罪名包括非法集結、 襲警、阻差辦公、藏有工具可作非法用途、藏有攻擊性武器同埋公眾地方行為不檢等等。而喺呢個週末所拘捕嘅157名嘅被捕人士裏面，有67人係學生，佢哋主要涉及一啲非法集結嘅罪名。而呢67人係即係代表咗喺157人裏面嘅43%。對於呢個咁大嘅比分嚟講咧，我哋覺得呢個趨勢係相當之令人擔憂。而就正如我上星期曾經提及過，希望所有嘅年輕人同埋學生喺作出任何違法行為之前，都停一停，諗一諗，究竟自己係做緊一啲乜嘢嘅事，會唔會令到自己抱憾終生呢？法庭案件方面，喺上個星期日，即係9月22日嘅元朗暴力示威案件裏面，警方喺9月27日係拘捕咗一名25歲同埋一名30歲嘅男子，佢哋係分別已經被控咗傷人罪同埋襲擊致造成身體傷害同埋刑事毀壞罪，亦都已經喺今朝早喺粉嶺裁判法院提堂。而喺上星期六9月21日喺屯門發生嘅暴力事件裏面，警方喺昨日拘捕咗一名27歲嘅女子縱火罪，今日佢已經喺粉嶺裁判法院提堂。而另外，我哋呢一名女子，我哋亦都係涉嫌佢係曾經參與琴日喺銅鑼灣嘅一個襲警嘅事件，而佢亦都係已經被暫控襲警罪嘅。咁呢一個罪行咧，亦都係今日咧已經喺粉嶺裁判法院嗰度提堂。咁我哋嘅警務人員受傷方面咧，咁喺過去呢個週末嘅行動裏面，我哋共有8名嘅警務人員受傷，主要受傷咧都係喺拘捕同埋驅散過程裏面，係俾一啲嘅暴力示威者圍毆啦，又或者喺個拘捕過程裏面，拘捕嘅人士咧就作出一啲反抗，於是乎我哋嘅同事受傷。使用彈藥方面，在星期五9月27日，我們並沒有使用任何彈藥的。而在星期六9月28日，我們共使用4枚的催淚彈。而在昨日9月29日星期日，我們共使用催淚彈328枚、橡膠子彈306枚、布袋彈95枚和海綿彈79枚的。澄清方面，我哋見到有一啲嘅指控，話我哋有一啲嘅便衣嘅人員喺琴日喺灣仔嘅港鐵站嗰度曾經做一啲縱火嘅行為。我哋喺呢一度係絕對否認呢一啲冇根據嘅指控嘅。而我哋警方喺任何行動裏面都係唔會做出呢一啲縱火嘅違法行為。而我哋喺採取唔同嘅執法行動嘅時候，最終目的都係維持公共安全同埋公共秩序嘅。而暴徒每次喺做完一啲嘅違法事件之後，嘗試將責任推落去一啲便裝嘅警務人員身上咧，係極之不負責任嘅。而我相信公眾亦都對呢一啲推卸責任嘅一啲嘅狡辯咧，亦都係已經感到相當之厭倦。咁之後落嚟嘅時間，我就交俾消防處嘅陳 Sir。 唔該，
唔該。係各位傳媒朋友，咁我會交代翻喺星期六日發生嘅示威同埋聚眾活動嘅情況嘅。咁消防處喺星期六咧，係雖然冇接獲任何關於示威同埋聚眾活動有關嘅火警報告，但其實大家都見到喺港島區政府總部附近咧，都有出現一啲焚燒雜物啦，同埋向政府總部投擲汽油彈嘅情況嘅。不過由於係警方即刻就已經將嗰個火勢滅咗，咁所以咧就唔需要我哋嘅協助。咁而喺星期日方面咧，消防處接獲同示威同埋聚眾活動有關嘅火警數字咧，總共有25宗。其中集中在港島區有21宗，九龍區有1宗，而新界區亦都有3宗。 示威者在銅鑼灣、灣仔、金鐘一帶多處築起路障和燃燒雜物，堵塞交通，亦有投擲汽油彈。其中示威者在灣仔菲林明道向行車天橋投擲多枚汽油彈，導致火光處處，期間亦都波及附近一座大廈，燒著了外牆的海報。在軒尼斯道和菲林明道一帶亦都有示威者在馬路上燃燒雜物，期間好像剛才的片段大家都見到，有人帶同石油氣罐到現場。本處必須指出，石油氣罐遇熱會令到裡面的氣體急速膨脹，有可能造成爆炸，而這個爆炸的衝擊的方向和那些碎片會彈去哪個方向呢？其實大家都預計不到，所以會對在場的人士造成非常嚴重的傷亡和破壞。另外，示威者亦都在銅鑼灣、灣仔等的港鐵站出口堆起雜物焚燒，其中在近修頓球場的港鐵站出口火勢相當之猛烈。此外，在港鐵太子站和大圍站附近亦曾經出現縱火事件。消防署重申，投擲汽油彈和縱火都是非常危險的行為，除了會直接引起火警，威脅在場人士的安全，濃煙和火勢亦都會危及附近的市民，後果是不堪設想。另外，因應示威和聚眾活動，本署會調配我們的行動資源，包括我們的消防車和救護車，在聚眾活動的沿線策略性位置戒備，以提供最快捷的滅火和緊急救援服務。雖然是這樣，但是堵塞道路、堵塞建築物和公共設施的出入口，仍然會對本處提供的緊急服務構成嚴重影響。消防處在這裡呼籲各位人士要保持克制，以及顧及所有市民的安全，停止以上的行為。此外，本處亦都再一次提醒市民要保持警覺，遠離危險的區份，不要圍觀。記者的朋友亦都一樣要注意你們自身的安全。另外，我們在網上亦都見到一段片段，關於在金鐘港鐵站有人在出閘口的底爬出來，而同時有兩名消防人員在現場的一件事。消防處在昨日9月29日下午的4時58分是收到一宗緊急救護服務，同時我們亦都派出了一輛有先遣急救員的消防車前赴現場處理，地點是統一中心星展銀台對出。當消防車抵達的時候，有多名人士上前接觸該車的主管，表示在金鐘港鐵站出口有大量傷者，需要消防的救援。這名主管即時將他的隊員分開成兩小隊，一隊繼續前往處理先遣急救的召喚，另一隊包括他自己和一名隊目就跟隨上述的人士去港鐵站。當主管和隊目抵達港鐵站閘口的位置的時候，發現那個卷閘是停留了在大家見到的有關位置，並且目睹多名人士在那個閘底度爬出來。因為擔心到會發生人搭人的意外，以及要了解究竟是否有大量的傷者，所以主管就派出了該名隊目去閘前了解，以及提供了協助給部分的人士。整個過程之中，消防人員並未有使用任何工具去撬開相關的卷閘。我的匯報是到這裡。
好，接下來我會跟大家說說接下來在港島明天10月1日一些有關已通知或者是警方的一些公眾這些公眾活動，我們警方想對公眾人士作出一些勸喻。就其實較早前我們已經收到一個通知了，就是在明天這個一個公眾集會和遊行。咁集會嘅起點咧就係圍園啦，咁啊沿住佢以往嘅一貫嘅路線咧，就係經過銅鑼灣、灣仔，就以遮打道行人專用區為終點嘅，咁啊人數200,000人啦。咁警方咧最終咧經過咗我哋嘅一啲風險評估之後啦，咁最終咧我哋係向呢個主辦單位咧發出咗不反對通知書，咁而主辦單位咧亦都係向呢個公眾集會及遊行上訴委員會提出了上訴。在今早上訴委員會已經作出了裁決，就是駁回有關的上訴，即是簡單來說，有關的公眾的遊行 同埋集會咧，已經係予以係反對同埋禁止。警方咧係歡迎有關嘅決定啦。特別啦，其實我哋想強調就係，其實我哋每一次作出呢一啲反對咧，都係以一個審慎嘅態度啦，去審視每一個個案嘅。咁今次我哋亦都係特別，頭先好似正如阿謝 Sir 所講，今次嘅風險亦都係特別大。咁我哋平衡咗公共安全、公共秩序，同埋以保障其他人嘅利益同埋自由之後咧，而作出今次嘅決定嘅。喺過去三個月裏邊咧，我諗大家見到嗰個暴力嘅程度咧係不斷升級啦。咁喺我哋今次喺上訴裏邊咧，我哋亦都有向上訴委員會咧去呈達我哋警方嘅關注。我想強調咧，我哋警方提出上訴嘅理據咧，並非係針對任何團體，又或者係針對任何日子，而係一個平衡咗我哋各方面嘅風險之後咧所作出嘅決定嚟嘅。我哋會見到啦，特別係喺最近啦，咁暴力嘅程度係越演越烈啦。咁喺示威者所使用嘅武器，有磚頭啊、鋼珠啊、一啲尖嘅竹枝啊，甚至乎喺過去呢兩日，我哋會見到已經係大規模咁樣使用一啲汽油彈啦。咁亦都係嗰個成分，亦都係經過咗改良，係非常之危險嘅。咁佢哋呢啲行為咧，其實對於參與呢一啲公眾活動嘅人士咧，同埋警務人員咧，都會構成嚴重嘅威脅嘅。我哋會見到啦，其實除咗呢一啲威脅之外咧，透過咁大量人士嘅聚集咧，同一時間咧，其實佢哋亦都會借呢個機會咧，破壞好多香港重要嘅基建設施啦。咁好似我哋尋日見到，包括呢個港鐵站啦。紅磡海底隧道一啲收費亭啊、交通燈啊等等，咁喺過往咧都已經咧係發生過。咁我哋整體咧係就住今次咧十一嘅活動啦，咁我哋亦都特別再見到咧，其實喺幾個星期前咧已經有好多網上嘅一啲宣傳咧，係教人咧係製作一啲汽油彈，另外咧亦都係煽動其他人咧喺呢一個日子咧係利用汽油彈咧作出攻擊。咁我哋情報顯示咧，有激進者啦，亦都會係利用呢一個大型公眾嘅活動咧，去作出一啲咧好嚴重危害公共安全、公共秩序嘅暴力行為。咁呢一啲行為咧，我哋係絕對咧相信咧係會對於參與者、市民大眾、在場嘅記者或者係警務人員咧嘅人身財產安全咧構成極大嘅呢一個風險嘅。咁所以咧，我哋亦都係作出咗呢一個上訴嘅決定啦。咁亦都歡迎佢有呢一個裁決。我哋見到咧，除咗呢一個活動之外咧，其實喺網上咧，亦都透過社交媒體咧，係有好多唔同嘅一啲人士或者係一啲單位咧，係呼籲市民咧係舉辦參與唔同嘅活動。咁當中呢一啲活動咧，其實係包括全港九新界各區咧。都有嘅，咁我必須要提醒啦。咁咁多位市民啦，如果你哋係參與一啲已經遭警方禁止或者反對嘅集會咧，係必須要理解咧。本身呢一個行為已經可能係構成咧干犯參與未經批准集結嘅一個罪行，而根據翻《公安條例》第245章17A 咧，最高刑罰咧係監禁5年。咁我希望即係市民咧。係必須要係考慮清楚先至好參加有關嘅活動，亦都咧係咧，如果喺你身邊咧係正在發生緊呢一啲咁高危嘅情況、有危險嘅時候咧，我哋都再次呼籲咧市民咧係盡早離開嚇，唔好參與係其中嘅。咁接住落嚟咧，我交俾灣仔分區指揮官周紅警司，又講講灣仔區升旗典禮嘅安排。
唔該。各位接住嚟咧，我係同大家簡述一下，聽日喺香港會議展覽中心舉行十一國慶升旗嘅安排。咁為咗配合升旗典禮嘅舉行，會展半島同埋灣仔北一帶嘅道路咧係已經封閉。封閉嘅路段咧包括有整個會展半島，當中包括博覽道、博覽道中、博覽道東。中環和灣仔繞道通往灣仔北的出口， 同埋喺介乎博覽道中與會議道之間一段嘅非臨明道。另外，介乎喺龍合街同博覽道東之間嘅一段龍和道，同埋灣仔及中環及灣仔繞道通往龍和道嘅路咧，都係封閉咗。警方喺呢度呼籲駕駛人士應該係配合現場交通封路嘅安排，同埋遵從現場警務人員嘅指示。此外咧，以往係有團體喺當日咧都會去到灣仔北進行公眾嘅活動嘅。咁警方嘅政策係協助市民進行一啲和平理性嘅公眾活動。警方會喺當日咧調配適當嘅人手，去確保公共嘅安全同埋公眾嘅秩序，令到星期嘅典禮係可以順利進行。咁啊，時間我交翻俾謝 Sir。
我會做一個總結。我諗過去咧，大家從來都冇諗過咧，恐怖主義呢四個字咧，會同香港咧越行越近。正如以往大家都冇諗過，我諗香港會發現每個星期有大量嘅暴徒大肆咁樣投擲汽油彈一樣。呢個挑戰咧係前所未見嘅。我必須重申，警方係有信心，亦都有能力去處理任何可能出現的一些暴力事件，我們亦都已經安排足夠的人手去應付一些突發的場面。維持社會秩序和和平不是我們警方單方面可以做到，最重要一定是市民配合警方執法，停止一切違法的行為。警方在這裡呼籲，請大家停止衝擊警方的防線，停止放火，停止襲擊不同意見的人士，停止破壞一些公共設施，停止阻礙警方驅散或者拘捕的行動。遇到這些情況的時候，警方在沒有選擇的情況下必定會果斷執法。縱使暴徒聲稱的主張和理念有多崇高，縱使暴徒有多不滿，只要暴徒做的任何形式的暴力，或者做出任何違法的行為，所有聲稱的理念和主張其實都是藉口。這些無視法紀的行為不會符合社會大眾的期望。情況如果繼續惡化下去，代價並不是香港社會能夠承受。過去三個月的暴力情況不斷上升，我們相信明天的情況亦都會非常危險，亦都會存在很多不確定性。到這一刻，究竟我們仍然選擇跟它越行越近，還是決定懸崖勒馬呢？接下來我會用英文講一講簡單剛才那個中文廣告。 Hong Kong has entered its 17th week of the social unrest and rise spread violence. Mass property destruction, furious street fires, indiscriminate attacks on innocent citizens, and petrol bombs galore. Rioters wreak havoc across the city. We are on the verge of extreme danger. Before I talk about the rampage over the weekend, I would like to talk about some alarming observations ahead of the National Day tomorrow. We have got intelligence suggesting that some hardcore violence protesters are inciting others, including those with suicide tendency, to commit extreme acts like as murdering the police, disguising as police officer to kill others, and setting fires in petrol stations, etc. With the increase in the intensity and extensity of violence over the past 3 months, there are apparent signs that hardcore violence will escalate in the near future. All acts are one step closer to terrorism. We are deeply concerned about the public safety tomorrow, and we express the strongest condemnation against all criminal and violent acts. On Saturday, different public order events on Hong Kong Island quickly descend into chaos as rioters charged at police officers, start street fires, and hurled petrol bombs recklessly at various locations. On one occasion, some even point laser beam at a helicopter in the air, seriously endangering public safety. The rampage carried on yesterday when rioters' brutality has left many public facilities, infrastructure mainly MTR stations, in ruins. They set ablaze barricades and trash, starting fires in Admiralty, Wan Chai and Causeway Bay. As many as 100 petrol bombs were thrown by rioters in two short days. On one occasion, while our officers were subduing an arrested person on Admiralty Row, some rioters threw petrol bombs right in their direction. Some rioters even threw petrol bombs at ground floor shops on Fleming Row, Wan Chai, endangering the safety of ordinary residents. This proves their brutality is indiscriminate. In addition, the ugly scene of mobs randomly throwing punches and kicks as civilians on the street left a scar in everyone's heart. Rioters took justice in their own hands and harshly beat up people who are not on their side. In one heartbreaking scene, one man was beaten up and sprayed with black paint in the face by rioters in the presence of his crying young son and family members. We strongly condemn such indiscriminate attacks on innocent citizens. Moving on, the police has issued a letter of objection to a public order event proposed to be held on Hong Kong Island tomorrow. We objected to the application out of concern about public safety, public order, and protection of rights and freedom of others after conducting a detailed risk assessment. The organizer has filed an appeal to the appeal board on public meetings and public procession, which eventually upheld our decision. We welcome and respect the appeal board result. We would like to remind members of the public that taking part in an unauthorized assembly is a criminal offense under the Public Order Ordinance. Also, we all have another reminder for the members of the public regarding the arrangement of the National Day flag raising ceremony tomorrow. Please note that multiple major roads in Wan Chai, especially in the vicinity of the Hong Kong Convention and Exhibition Centre, will be closed. Drivers and travellers are advised to stay tuned to the latest traffic arrangement and follow the instructions of police officers directing traffic. Now I move on to an update on arrest figures. One Saturday, we arrested 11 people, consisting of 8 males and 3 females, aged between 16 and 63 years old. Their offences include criminal damage and common assault. On Sunday, we arrested 146 people, consisting 118 males and 28 females, aged between 12 and 53 years old. Their offences include unlawful assembly, possession of offensive weapons, disorderly conduct in public place, etc. Out of the 157 arrested people, 67 of them were students. Most of them were arrested for unlawful assembly. Among them, 8 were only aged between 12 to 15 years old. Again, we are very worried about the trend of more youngsters committing crimes. This will have a detrimental impact on their future. In conclusion, I believe most Hong Kong people would not have imagined these prolonged social unrest and widespread of violence could have crippled our city for the 17th week. It's high time to halt all forms of violence, or else these hardcore rioters will push Hong Kong to the verge of extreme danger. We have this urgent appeals. Please stop gathering in front of police cordon. Stop charging at police officers. Stop starting fires. Stop assaulting innocent citizens. And stop damaging public properties. We all should stand together to stem our violence right now. Thank you.
問題時間，前排第一位白色衫嗰位。
你好，你好 ，TVB 記者小智。我想首先問一問聽日嘅部署，因為網上有講話，即係商場、馬場、機場啊，仲有啲港島嘅遊行，亦都有六區嘅集會。想問下聽日會係有咩部署方法，同埋點樣去應對啦？啱啱亦都提過話呢個離恐怖主義係越行越近，咁啊，但係點解仲維持喺中度呢個恐怖襲擊嘅水平咧？咁面對呢一個趨勢，你哋會警力方面同埋武器方面，聽日會唔會提升咧？呢個第一個。第二條問題想問翻琴日嘅 琴日嘅一啲執法行動，就係、是、見到好似同以前有少少唔同。以前可能係等一啲破壞係去到一定程度先去執法，咁琴日見到好似一開波晏晝兩點幾就已經有一啲嘅拘捕同埋制服行動。想問下係咪改變咗以往嘅一啲策略，同埋喺政總對出嘅一啲嘅三面包抄嘅一啲嘅行動，最後喺金鐘道有一個大型嘅拘捕嘅行動。呢方面係有冇即係如你所願，即係可能係針對一啲激進嘅暴力示威者嘅一啲嘅拘捕行動，有冇係做到啦、達到啦？最後一條問題就想問下灣仔個喬裝示威者嘅警察方面嘅行動，最後都係結果都係要鳴槍示警先可以解決到。咁呢個策略其實以後會唔會係去檢視？會唔會擔心即係有啲警務人員都會遇到危險，同埋即係佢哋有佢哋嘅安危嘅問題咧？唔該。
好啊，咁我第一條問題咧，我會先解答關於你頭先所提及過嗰個恐怖主義嗰個情況。咁我之後咧會邀請阿廖 Sir 去講講聽日一啲部署。咁第二條關於琴日嘅一啲即係執法嗰個策略咧，我會邀請阿方 Sir 一間。咁最後嗰條一間關於喬裝嗰個情況，我會交俾阿李 Sir。咁我諗頭先咧喺我嘅講稿一開始都講咗，其實喺我諗過去過去三個月或者過去呢段日子裏面，其實我哋睇到暴徒的暴力程度係越嚟越高。他哋的攻擊是越嚟越有策略、有組織，而且他哋攻擊用的武器亦都係殺傷力係越嚟越大。咁警方的情報亦都顯示咧，有部分的呢啲暴力的核心分子咧，其實是正策劃緊一些不同類型的一啲襲擊。我剛才其實提及過部分，其實他們有些是計劃緊怎樣去殺害警務人員，假扮警務人員去殺害其他人而嫁禍給警務人員。他們有說在港鐵，亦都見到他們有些已經付諸實行，在港鐵站裡面投擲汽油彈，有說在商場裡面投擲汽油彈，亦都有說過會在油站放火。更有些人是招募一些本身已經有自殺傾向的人呢，去參加他們這些行動，期望造成更大傷亡的一些事情。我們看到其實這些行動的升級呢，他們的暴力影響的深度和廣度呢，其實呢都是越來越厲害，而且有別於以往的情況，今次我們看到很多網上的情報都是針對著明天即是10月1號而發出的一些大規模殺傷的行動。所以我剛才所說，就是說現在一些暴力的行為和恐怖主義的行為是越行越近。對於明天的情況，其實警方是表是感到是非常之擔憂的，不能夠預測明天那個整體那個襲擊情況會去到什麼地步。但剛才我重申，警方絕對有能力亦都有準備去處理相關這些事件。你提及到那個恐襲那個威脅程度呢，我要重申現在香港那個恐襲威脅的程度呢仍然維持在中度的水平。但是就著近日事態的發展，一些極度暴力的行為，剛才提及過我們非常之擔憂，我們會繼續留意著一些情報，會作出很緊密的分析呢，因應著事態的發展，會同相關的政府部門密切溝通，陸續一路要去評估住一個風險程度的情況。咁我而家話要交俾阿廖 Sir 講講聽日一啲部署。
我諗頭先正如阿謝 Sir 所講啦，其實嚟緊咧，亦都見到喺網上咧已經有好多大大小小嘅唔同嘅活動，正在喺度呼籲緊、籌辦緊、鼓勵緊啲人去參加。咁而呢一啲活動咧，那個涉獵嘅地點啊、時間啊、性質啊，亦都係相當之廣泛。當中除咗港島其中一個主要嘅地方之外咧，頭先都提過九龍啊、新界啊，咁喺全日唔同嘅時間咧都係有。咁我想講咧，今次佢哋所帶嚟嘅風險係相當之高啦。咁亦都令到我哋面對嘅工作亦都係相當之困難。我想講嘅就係咧，我哋警方喺咁困難嘅環境底下咧，所用嘅即係策略咧，必定要更加去有效， 去做呢？因為咁多地方同一時間，我哋面對每一個呢一啲情報呢，都會用一個好認真、好審慎嘅態度去處理，亦都會係作出一啲相應嘅部署。咁喺咁困難底下呢，其實我亦都要呼籲，更加需要呢，包括市民大眾啦，或者係記者啦，喺現場嘅配合啦，令到我哋即係更有效去處理每一個嘅事件。咁整體嚟講咧，我哋希望咧，即係亦都呼籲啦，如果市民遇到呢啲咁嘅情況，亦都唔好停留啦，因為嗰個一方面，頭先我哋提過，本身已經有機會咧構成咗一個罪行嚇，根據呢個公安條例。另外一方面咧，對於佢自身嘅安全咧，都會係有一定嘅危險。咁我最後要強調咧，就係話警方執法咧，無論我哋個調配係點樣都好咧，我哋嘅行動目的必定咧係都係維持翻公共安全、公共秩序為我哋首要任務。
咁就住琴日喺即係港島區發生嘅一啲情況，我哋嘅部署，我哋交俾阿方 Sir。
好，唔該阿 Sir。咁我哋都了解咧，社會其實對我哋警方咧武力使用或者我哋點樣使用武力咧，係有一定程度嘅關注。咁但係咧，與此同時咧，我哋都希望咧，大家可以了解到就係話，究竟我哋喺咩情況底下使用武力，何時何地，或者我哋使用何種武力咧？基本上我哋係處於咧一個非常之被動嘅狀態。我哋要視乎咧，究竟我哋警員同事喺當其時實際環境。喺實際環境咧，遇到啲乜嘢程度嘅暴力，我哋先會決定咧去使用我哋嘅武力嘅。咁首先咧，都想指出咧，其實琴日喺港島區呢一個遊行咧，或者呢個集會咧，係一個未經批准嘅集結嚟嘅。本身喺嗰度集結已經係違法嘅啦。咁同埋咧，喺根據我哋現場所見咧，其實喺琴日喺港島總區嗰度咧，都已經係發生咗不少一啲衝擊嘅事件啦。而我哋睇到咧，一啲暴力示威者佢哋裝備咧，我哋睇得到咧係有一個進一步提升暴力嘅跡象。咁所以咧，我哋係有責任咧及早咧係採取適當嘅行動。咁希望咧可以維持到呢個公共秩序同埋呢個公共安全咧不受到破壞。其次就係話，我哋嘅經驗話俾我聽咧，當人群咧進一步聚集咧，係有機會咧會出現更加一啲多一啲恐怖性嘅場面。我哋唔希望呢啲情況發生，咁所以咧就正如記者頭先你所講咧，我哋喺一個較早嘅時候咧，我哋希望咧就採取行動，咁啊使用咗一個相應嘅武力，希望咧可以停止到咧當其時嗰個非法集結。咁至於頭先咧，你亦都指出就係話喺聽日我哋嘅武力會否提升咧？咁我哋咧其實有信息想帶俾社會就係話。大家一直都關注咧，就係警方喺公眾活動嘅期間咧，會究竟我哋會唔會提升武力啊？或者我哋究竟會使用啲乜嘢武力層次？咁但係咧，其實我哋咧認為就係話嗰個關注咧，應該係放喺大家咧應該透過乜嘢形式去表達自己嘅訴求啊，而係警方咧係唔需要使用武力，係嘛？如果示威者能夠係用一個和平有序嘅形式咧去表達自己意見咧，我哋強調過好多次就係我哋根本咧係唔需要咧去考慮咧使用任何武力。我哋想指出咧，就係話喺表達訴求同埋呢一個奉公守法呢兩者咧，基本上咧係可以同時兼得，咁啊先至可以令到我哋嘅社會咧喺過往三個月嘅混亂情況、混亂場面底下咧，可以回復翻，盡快回復翻平靜同埋穩定。咁我頭先都同事都有提作出個呼籲啊，咁我都再講多次，就是、希望大家係用一個和平合法嘅形式去表達意見啦。我哋咧係絕對唔容忍任何咧暴力事件去發生。任何人咧，如果係用暴力或者用一種不負責任嘅手法咧，去破壞社會安寧或者去擾亂公眾秩序咧，我哋將會係不論所有人嘅背景，不論所有人嘅政治立場、身份，我哋必定咧係會嚴正執法。咁希望答到啲問題，唔該。
咁啊，最後一條關於個頭先你提及喬裝嗰個情況，我交俾阿李 Sir 啦。
係，其實咧喬裝行動或者我哋一啲派一啲便衣嘅人員咧，去一啲嘅現場入邊咧，做一啲嘅行動咧，並唔係一啲好新鮮嘅嘢嚟嘅嚇，不嬲都有噶啦，我哋都而行動嘅目標咧，亦都係多方面嘅啊，未必淨係拘捕嘅，有陣時可能做一啲近距離嘅觀察啊、搜證啊等等，我哋都會有。頭先記者先生問到啦，咁問係究竟係咪一個係好危險，需唔需要再考慮做唔做呢一類嘅行動咧？咁我哋必須承認咧，呢個係一個相當高風險嘅行動嚟㗎。你見到 佢哋嗰個嘅暴力嘅情況啦，根本我哋當時亦都未係採取任何嘅行動，佢已經係主動去攻擊我哋嘅同事㗎嚇，而且咧係唔係一啲拳頭嘅，係用一啲嘅武器去襲擊佢哋嘅。咁但係大家都感覺到㗎啦嚇，近呢三個月嚟咧，我哋面對嘅嘢係越嚟越暴力，越嚟越複雜。我哋警方其實會用任何嘅辦法咧，我哋都係會希望咧去盡量去遏止啲情況，包括拘捕、包括搜證、包括一啲觀察嘅。咁所以咧，如果我哋每一次嘅行動之初或者之後嘅時候咧，我哋都會去審視是否有效嘅。有兩個大前提我哋會做嘅，第一就係我哋嘅人員或者被捕人士嘅安全，而第二嘅咧就係我哋是否能夠達到我哋嘅行動目標。咁我喺度再同大家講咧，我哋警方係會用任何合法嘅辦法咧，去作出我哋一啲我哋應該要做嘅行動嘅。好，唔該。
阿偉，香港零一。
你好，香港零一，咁就有三條問題嘅，咁就想問翻第一條就係喺呢一個嘅金鐘啦，咁就琴日都有相或者片段去影到有防暴警員咧，就將示威者或者被捕者撳低之後咧，其實佢哋嘅手腳已經綁上噶啦，咁亦都有被拘捕嘅人佢哋話自己唞唔到氣，但係咧防暴警員仍然將佢壓住啦，咁亦都有防暴警咧有相即係影到佢哋用示威者嚟做人盾，咁就想問下其實警方所使用嘅呢一啲係咪合適？嘅武力有冇违反到守则？有冇罔顾被捕者嘅安全咧？咁就第二条问题咧，就系想问翻都系琴日嘅，咁就其实警方琴日咧就派出咗其实几多个乔装警员，有几多乔装警员系持有呢个配枪？咁而日后其实乔装警员系咪都会持有配枪呢一样嘢去执勤咧？咁市民其实点样可以辨别佢系一位示威者定系警员？会唔会系即系制服可疑人士嘅时候，点知就会反而被控告袭警？点样可以避免呢个情况发生？咁就其实同埋琴日有一个情况咧，就系有。可能是懷疑是喬裝警員，他們呢就在一句喊自己人自己人的情況下呢，就有防暴警員將他們帶入去這個灣仔的地鐵站裡面，其實是不是一句自己人就可以代表他是警察？其實市民可以怎樣分別呢？謝謝。
第一條我先交給江 Sir 作答，第二條關於喬裝的問題我就交給李 Sir。
咁咧就其實琴日喺呢個金鐘嘅一帶啦，我哋就拘捕咗好多人嘅。咁所以其實我暫時啊未係太清楚你係講緊邊個事件。咁但係一般而言咧，其實我哋同事去作出拘捕嘅時候咧，就係我哋都睇到近排嘅一啲嘅我先講咗我哋嗰個處理嘅方法先啦，係啦。咁我明白嘅，即係可能大家望落去就覺得啊，我哋已經將一個被捕人士可能已經撳咗喺地上邊啦，咁係啦。咁但係其實喺過程裏邊咧，其實我哋見到有唔同嘅事件啦，包括我喺琴日我自己都有睇過一啲片段都有嘅，就係其實撳咗地下之後咧，嗰個被捕人都仲係依然係掙扎當中啊，係啦。有個別我哋見到係佢將腳就向即係上方就踢啦，係啦。咁於是乎我哋同事又需要用翻一個相應嘅武力咧去將佢制服嘅，係啦。咁就算佢咧腳唔踢嘅話咧，我哋亦都有一啲情況見到咧，就係我哋同事都未落到手球，根本就落唔到，因為佢隻手其實係不停咁樣用力去掙扎，同我哋鬥力啦，或者我叫做係啦。咁變咗我哋同事係落唔到手球嘅情況下咧，我哋都未算係完全制服咗佢嘅，係啦。咁特別係我哋喺呢過去呢三個多月以嚟啦，我哋亦都見過唔少嘅情況咧，就係我哋喺制服一個被捕人士嘅過程裏面，咁跟住咧就會有其他人就會衝埋嚟，係啦，去阻住我哋做嘢也好，又或者再嚴重啲嘅埋嚟去襲擊我哋同事，意圖去搶飯。都好，係咁，所以我哋同事去制服一個人咧，並唔係就咁撳咗落去，即係將佢撳落地下就已經係完成呢個工作，係啦。咁其實我哋同事係需要去落埋手扣啦，將佢去押解去一個安全嘅地點啦。咁我哋成個嘅拘捕行動先算係完成嘅。而我哋喺呢度都重複過好多次，被捕人同埋我哋同事，以至到其他嘅在場嘅一啲和平嘅市民嘅安全，都係我哋好重要嘅考慮。而被捕人的保安這個都是我們考慮來的，既然他犯法，我們一定是會盡力 去將佢拘捕，係啊，我哋亦都唔會容許，我哋會極力去阻止有人係埋嚟搶犯嘅，係啦。咁所以我哋喺個武力使用方面，喺個拘捕過程嘅武力使用方面咧，其實大概就係循住呢個方向去做嘅。咁啊，跟住我就交俾阿李 Sir， 咁啊講翻嗰個第二條問題。或者我在這裡澄清一點，你所說的人盾是不是我們的同事拿著這些長槍的畫面？其實呢，那個呢就相當之尷尬，我們同事很忙的，其實是的，當時這個同事其實是一心幾用的，是的，他拿著這些長槍向前面方向的指向呢，其實因為前面有危險點發生，是的，前面都有大批不願意散開的一些的暴力示威者在他前面，而佢其實佢啱啱係完成咗拘捕嘅行動，啱啱落好咗手扣，佢都未及將呢一個被拘捕嘅人士帶走啊！前面已經又有另一班人湧埋嚟，係啦。咁所以其實就唔存在人盾呢一樣嘢嘅，係啦。只不過我哋嘅同事就係一方面要擎槍指住前面一個危險嘅方向，同時佢因為只得佢一個人，佢亦都要確保呢個被捕人士咧係完全係受到控制嘅。咁所以根本就唔存在人盾呢一樣嘢。况且我会话，之前在个开场白的时候，阿谢 Sir 都有提过，其实都冇话人唔人盾嘅。我哋见到那些暴徒根本啊，当我哋进行紧拘捕的时候，佢都照掉汽油弹埋去嗰个被捕人士的方向嘅，系啦。咁我想不存在人唔人盾啦，而是呢些被拘捕的人士，其实佢亦都是危险嘅，系啊。佢啲所谓的志同道合的示威者，亦都继续向紧嗰个方向攻击。咁所以我头先都讲咗，我哋希望尽快将被捕人士帶嚟嗰個地方。
關於咧就係頭先有記者問到係關於我哋嗰個嘅喬裝行動嘅人員啊，是否配槍等等嘅問題啦。咁呢個部分咧就我都唔會好方便好詳細透露，因為行動細節，因為我哋真係好希望呢一類嘅行動咧有效咁樣去做嘅。咁但係唯有一樣嘢咧，我哋就會點去決定咧？就因為我哋環境啦、任務啦，同埋佢所處嗰個風險嘅情況咧，而俾佢決定我哋嘅人數同埋佢是否配槍。至於就係講話點樣識別一啲嘅我哋嘅喬裝人員咧，咁大前提第一樣嘢咧就係，如果我哋一般嘅市民咧，我哋都唔建議去一啲咁高危嘅暴力嘅示威區入邊，咁就所以就唔需要去識別邊一啲係探員，邊一啲係一啲我哋嘅示威者啦。咁但係如果真係去到咁嘅情況嘅時候咧，有一樣嘢都好容易會察覺得到嘅嚇。如果我哋啲同事係需要採取一啲拘捕行動啦嚇，我哋假設係拘捕行動。嘅話咧，咁佢一定會話俾佢聽，佢係警務人員。第二嘅情況咧，就係話咧，如果佢哋係作出拘捕行動嘅時候咧，一定會將佢個目標人物咧係會暫時咧係會鎖上，咁啊壓喺地上啊，咁啊呢啲大家都會常見得到噶啦。如果你見到係其他啲暴力示威者就唔會嘅，打完咧佢就走噶啦。咁呢個係一個最大最大嘅分別。咁所以咧，但係亦都係一樣嘢啦。咁希望大家唔好或者呼籲其他啲人咧，唔好留喺一啲咁高危嘅啲示威區入邊咧，去令到自己更加危險。呢個反而最重要。好，唔該。
下位，第二行係咪 Channel News Asia？
Hi, I'm Wai Kit from CNA. Can I just ask, earlier, I think John says, talked about the protests being one step closer to terrorism. Can I just ask, previously, I think Li Xue has said before that the factors of terrorism depends on the intention and the actions. Can I ask what exactly have changed? And again, with the question of intention, given the significance of October 1st, if protesters still come out, would you regard protesters' intentions as terrorism-related? Again, I also want to ask, I think earlier you mentioned that the level of security is still at moderate level. Given that you've said there's intel showing that it's going to be very, very dangerous on October 1st, why is it still at moderate level?
Thank you.
Okay, I think the law doesn't change, but I'll invite Mr. Li to give you another explanation on the law later. I think what I mentioned, or I would like to further explain, is that I think over the past 3 months, it is evident that the violence being used by the hardcore violent protester, or what we call the hardliners, has escalated. I think the situation changed a lot. There's an increase in both the intensity and the extensity of the violence being used by these hardliners.
And it's also evidence that those organized groups go around Hong Kong to launch planted and brutal attacks. We can see a lot of similar incidents happen, like this indiscriminate attack on innocent citizens, and some mass property damage. And they throw over 100 of petrol bombs in the past weekend, and they also use offensive weapons to attack police officers. And there are also intelligence suggesting that some of these hardliners incite others, including those with suicide tendency, to commit extreme acts, like from what I've shown in the on the TV, they suggest others to murder the police, disguising as police officer to kill others, and even setting fires at petrol stations. That is very dangerous. All these hardliners continue to use hardcore violence, and these damage to society will be more widespread, endanger the safety of every member of the public in Hong Kong. And I think the intelligence we collect so far basically target the National Day tomorrow, and that's why, according to all the risk assessment, we are deeply concerned about the situation tomorrow. And may I invite Mr. Lee to talk about the law?
So in respect of the definitions for the Terrorist Act in Hong Kong, we basically relied on the United Nations Anti-Terrorism Measures Ordinance. As I mentioned before, that would be the in the two kind of element we have to prove the existing of the terrorism activities. The first one is the act itself, the serious violence against the persons, and the serious damage to properties, and also the endangers of the life in Hong Kong. That's the act we're looking for. And other important aspect is about the purpose. The purpose is, according to the definition, is to compel the government or the part of the public or the some international organization for the purpose of advancing and political and the religious ideologies causes. That was forming the two part of the definition for the tourism's activities. Echoing John's idea about that, in other than we looking in the every element of the offense, we you have to looking in the intensities of also the intelligence concerning these aspects before we design the grading for the situation we have now. Thank you.
下位，黄色三个位，后面第三行，
苹果日报嘅。想先問咧，就係第一條問題就係星期日咧喺政總嘅高位平台咧，就多間傳媒都影到係有一啲蒙咗面嘅疑似警務人員啦，咁啊同埋一啲著住紅衫嘅人士咧就喺天台，咁咧就期間咧就應該有人咧就從高而下咧就發射咗包括催淚彈等等嘅槍械或者武力。我想問一下咧，當時咧其實喺前後左右嘅時間咧，你哋已經係有呢個速龍小隊嘅警員咧就喺政總嘅一個門口衝出嚟咧就進行一個驅散行動。我想問點解會係喺高位向下去發射一啲嘅槍械同武力咧？咁啊，你哋警方其實一直都講咧，就話即係唔會盡量避免，或者唔會咧就喺高位就向下咧就去發射一啲嘅槍械或者點樣。咁而家係咪即係已經係將呢樣嘢變成一個驅散行動嘅一個常態？第二個咧就是、想問翻同一個時間咧，即係頭先講到速龍小隊嘅一個驅散行動喺下角道嗰個位置咧，就有多間傳媒影到咧，就係、是、有手持住胡椒球槍嘅警員咧，就係、是、喺目測距離係不足一米，甚至乎係非常之接近零距離嘅情況之下咧，就對住示威者嘅背部，佢哋當時後退緊嘅示威者嘅背部，就係、是、發射呢個胡椒球彈嘅。咁啊，方 Sir 就講過咧，就胡椒球彈嘅有效發射或者最短最安全嘅發射距離咧，就係、是、一至兩米。我想問事後有冇警員彙報過呢啲情況係喺 距離一米以內的情況之下發生。如果是的話，是不是全香港的警員當方 Sir 公開講的一些武力使用的指引是無道？第三個問題呢，就是想追問剛才那個卧底警員，我想問李 Sir， 那位卧底警員到現在有沒有回報過他當日鳴槍示警之前有沒有表明過自己是一個警員或者是一個卧底的警員？第二，李 Sir 你剛才說過了，即有兩個行動可以辨識到那個卧底警員是不是一個卧底警員，其中一個就是他會講自己身份，第二個就是他會扣起一些可疑的人士。我想問那個卧底警員有沒有進行過拘捕行動，拘捕了多少人，現在的情況是怎樣的？
好，有三條問題，第一條我先必須要澄清咧，就係我諗我喺呢個記者會裏面咁多日咧，我哋從來都冇講過話警方係唔可以喺高位發射任何嘅我哋嘅裝備。咁第三條嘅題目咧，亦都我諗一路我哋都唔係講緊卧底警嘅。咁啊，即係我先澄清咗先啦。咁啊，嚟緊嘅第一、二條咧，我會交俾阿方 Sir 作答。咁啊，第三條我一間都會交俾阿李 Sir。
好，唔該阿 Sir。其實昨日嗰個金鐘嗰個環境咧，咁我都希望大家再仔細諗一諗，究竟咧喺金鐘下角道一帶咧，大家所見到嘅畫面咧係一個乜嘢嘅畫面先？根據我哋嘅統計咧，單單淨係喺金鐘下角道一帶、政府總部一帶咧，暴力示威者暴徒咧，佢哋所用過嘅汽油彈，已燃燒咗嘅汽油彈咧，擲向我哋警方嘅方向，或者投入去呢一個政府總部嘅位置咧。是大概是有50个，代表住啲咩咧？代表住就係話喺一個咁短嘅時間入邊咧，暴力示威者咧係採取咗一個極端嘅形式咧，去表達佢嘅訴求。咁因此咧，其實咧，我哋係亦都係需要採取一個相應嘅行動。咁究竟我哋點解會喺高位度去作出部署咧？咁其實喺過往嘅記者會入邊咧，我哋都有提及到咧，就係話我哋喺呢一個武力嘅使用，或者我哋一個戰術上嘅使用咧，我哋係需要咧確保我哋嘅做法咧，第一我哋同時係安全啦，第二咧就係希望咧我哋嘅戰術上嘅運用咧能夠有效作出驅散。點解會用呢一個催淚煙去作出驅散咧，就係話，其實我哋都講過好多次，就係話希望咧可以咧可以透過催淚煙咧，製造咗一個安全嘅距離，從而咧可以咧作出即係達到呢一個驅散嘅作用。如果我哋唔用催淚煙嘅説話咧，莫非大家係想見到一個短兵相接嘅情況出現咧？我哋就係希望咧可以避免咗呢個情況，希望咧可以咧令到雙方，不論係我哋警方或者係示威者嘅傷亡嘅程度咧，或者受傷嘅程度咧，都可以減到最低。因此咧，我哋先為呢個做法。而至於頭先都好快都講一講，就係話你有提及到咧喺高處度咧有我哋速龍嘅我哋特別戰術大隊嘅同事，即係大家俗稱速龍嘅同事喺度啦，蒙住面，咁亦都有一啲著紅色衫。我想指出咧，就係紅色衫嘅同事咧都係我哋嘅警務人員嚟嘅，佢係我哋一個叫高空工作隊嘅成員嚟嘅。咁佢喺嗰度嘅目的咧，其實就係協助住我哋嘅同事咧，喺一個比較高點嘅位置咧進行工作，咁啊確保咧可以提供支援咧，同埋提供協助嘅。咁另外咧就係話使用胡椒球發射器、胡椒球發射裝置呢一個範疇都大家都我哋都有一段時間冇提及到啦。咁啊唔好意思，如果係我冇記錯嘅説話咧，就係我哋咧係冇講過咧話呢一個最短嘅射程咧係1至2米，因為咧我記憶所及咧，我經常都係會話咧就呢個最短嘅發射距離同埋最長嘅發射距離咧。是真的涉及到我們一些行動上的部署和一些戰術上的安排，所以呢我們是真的不方便向大家透露。而我們等我先說完，不好意思。而我們上次的答案呢，就是說在一個場景裡面，我們的同事發射胡椒球發射器，我的說法呢就是說當其時他們的距離，我們的同事發射這個胡椒球裝置、胡椒球發射器呢，它是符合著這個生產商或者這個武器製造商提供到給我們的指引的，這個是我當其時的說法。所以就是說在昨天那個狀況底下呢，其實我們同事呢，我都有看到過現場的直播，也都翻看了多次呢，我們的同事呢在現場使用這個胡椒球發射裝置的時候呢，那個距離我都倍加留意。我都可以肯定啊，喺琴日嗰個情況底下咧，我哋咧嘅同事咧係跟足住呢一個武器生產商俾我嘅指引，並沒有違規。咁啊，希望咧可以解答到你嘅問題。
係咪即係肯定警員會報告我哋社會，即係
哦，唔好意思啊，呢個我漏答咗你。根據我哋嘅武力嘅使用嘅指引咧，我哋嘅同事咧使用個槍械之後咧，係必須要彙報嘅。咁我哋可以確認咧，我哋嘅同事咧係有進行彙報嘅。咁啊，當然啦，就係話嗰個點算方面可能會多少啲時間啦。咁啊如果你要問我數字嘅説話咧，我就喺呢一刻咧，我確實都冇準備到。咁但係咧，就住我哋整個大嘅原則，就係話當我哋使用過武力，尤其是係使用過呢一類型嘅裝置、呢一類型嘅裝備之後咧，我哋咧係有一個嚴謹嘅指引咧，我哋同時係需要進行彙報，好嘛？唔該曬。
好，咁啊，第三條我交俾阿李尚。係。
或者我講翻詳細少少，就係琴日嗰個情況係點啦。咁其實咧，佢哋我哋幾位喬裝嘅同事啊，記住喬裝好緊要嘅，就唔同我哋嘅卧底探員，我哋有另一種嘅講法嚟㗎。所以希望大家咧要明白啲喬裝嘅咧，最主要咧就話咧行近一個目標。盡量去到一個近的目標入邊咧，執行佢嘅任務咁嘅。咁但係咧，其實琴日嘅狀況咧，就係咧，我哋嘅同事咧，基本上咧係未開始準備執行嘅任務嘅時候咧，已經咧係有人話佢係警察，咁然之後咧就開始襲擊佢哋。開頭嘅時候咧係用呢個嘅拳頭嘅，臨尾嘅時候佢攞啲武器嚟嘅時候咧就向佢哋大肆嘅襲擊。最尾嘅時候咧，我哋嘅同事咧就別無他法啦，唯有咧就係鳴槍示警咧先至可以脫身到。嗱，依個係個情況嚟㗎。佢重點我想大家睇就係話咧，而家一啲嘅人咧，一啲嘅暴力示威者咧已經係到達一個階段咧，就係話咧佢已經係唔係話去拒捕啊，而係話咧佢懷疑係身邊嘅係警察嘅時候咧，佢已經開始襲擊。或者大家可以睇翻禮拜六，好似如果我冇記錯嘅咧，喺銅鑼灣亦都有相近嘅事件。而嗰位咧唔係探員，唔係一啲喬裝嘅示威者咧，亦都俾人哋咧有一度好大嘅恐嚇咁嘅。咁我補充係咁多，唔該。
信報。
喂 ，Testing， 你好，信報，都想問翻啦，因為其實OK， 好，因為琴日咧，即係其實喺灣仔嘅天橋上面，其實有一名即係幫一個本地印尼語媒體嘅一個女記者，其實被即係你哋嘅警員係用應該係布袋彈係打中眼啦。我想問，其實即係都係同一樣問題，就係究竟有冇收到警員去彙報翻啦？同埋就係當時個環境，即係究竟即係其實。當嗰時警員係走緊啦，咁即係去發射槍，即係嗰個港媒嘅子彈嘅時間，其實面前其實只有記者，咁點解仲會去發射嗰仲會開槍咧？即係究竟其實呢個係咪即係個指引係點寫，同埋係咪即係喺一個咁嘅情況之下，係咪有訓練不足，即係見到記者都仲係會開槍呢樣嘢係啦？同埋就係、是、即係會唔會警方會唔會去主動去跟進調查翻即係涉事嘅警員啦？呢個係第一個問題。第二個問題就係琴日其實都有媒體去即係影到一啲嘅片段，就係即係有警員即係向記者去噴一個胡椒噴霧嘅時候，個樣係即係笑住咁噴啦。其實都想問翻，其實係咪即係警方對於即係記者喺示威現場去採訪係有啲嘅意見啦，或者甚至乎係有不滿？點解即係甚至乎有啲即係胡椒有呢咁嘅針對行動啦？想問翻即係點解啦？係啦，咁暫時呢兩個問題先。
我先回答第一條啦，咁就其實琴日就我諗大家喺唔同嘅網上片段或者媒體咧，其實睇到咧，其實當刻咧就大家見到咧喺橋上面其實發生緊咩事咧，就係有大量嘅暴徒，其實沿住條橋咧就將警方咧向住告士打道嘅方向咧壓過去，咁啊警察去到告士打道嗰個位就。在橋那裡就向樓梯那個方向就落樓梯的情況如果大家認真去看回片段其實看到呢當時其實有大量的暴徒呢是向我們的警務人員呢是擲一些硬物也都手持住一些汽油彈而我們的同事在樓梯的時候呢是向橋上面有發過一發的布袋彈跟住之後，佢哋其實落到橋下面咧，係仍然俾橋上面嘅暴徒咧襲擊，向橋下面掟咗兩個汽油彈落去，其中一個係爭啲擊中咗我哋其中一個警務人員。咁所以咧，我想講咧，其實當陣時嘅整體情況就喺橋上面，大家係見到有記者嘅，我同意。但係其實橋上面有好多好暴力嘅暴徒咧，係襲擊緊我哋嘅警務人員。咁所以嗰刻咧，我哋嘅同事喺別無選擇之下咧，佢就用咗相應嘅武力去處理。咁但係我可以肯定，佢並不會刻意瞄住個記者去作出呢一個射擊。 咁第二樣嘢就係、對於有記者喺一啲暴力嘅示威場面裏面咧，期間受傷咧，我哋係表示慰問嘅。我哋亦都非常關注呢個事件，亦都主動介入了解呢個事件咧。透過印尼領事館嘅代表咧，其實亦都接觸咗事主。咁事主現階段咧係需要休養，所以我哋未能夠同佢攞到口供。咁但係咧，我哋得知。其實咧，佢係會喺稍後嘅時間咧，會經過律師嘅代表咧，向警方作出正式嘅投訴嘅。咁所以現階段咧，我就唔會就住琴日嘅事件裡面一啲太詳細嘅內容咧，去作出進一步嘅資料提供啦。咁我想再喺度再次強調咧，其實示威嘅場面係非常之危險，尤其是喺過去幾星期、過去呢個週末咧，其實我哋睇到暴徒係用緊大量嘅致命武器，包括。昨天我所講在橋上面後面他掟了兩個汽油彈落橋下面好希望再在這裡藉這個機會呢能夠即呼籲各位的記者或者其實在現場的市民呢是要必須要找一個安全的位置呢進行你們的工作其實我們看到呢在部分的片段裡面看到呢其實那一刻在聽到那一下聲響之前咧，其實咧係都有暴徒喺前面係路過，咁所以咧，我諗對於記者嚟講，喺一啲而家已經去到咁暴力嘅場面裏面咧，係必須要先處理好自己嗰個人身安全，因為你見到其實警察都俾佢哋進攻到係要後退，亦都係落到橋都會俾人掟汽油彈嘅時候咧，我諗記者喺過去嘅情況亦都即係有時有意外咧，係會俾。一啲物件襲擊到，甚至俾汽油彈掟到，咁所以咧我喺度呼籲多次，記者必須要喺呢啲情形下咧確保自己人身安全。咁大致上呢一條咁多，咁第二條咧我會交俾阿江 Sir 作答。
咁咧就就住你第二條嗰個嘅情況啦，依我嘅理解啦，咁就當時係大概係晚上時分啦，咁我哋同事就喺軒尼斯道嗰度正在工作嘅，咁而喺我哋同事前面咧，其實係有幾百名嘅示威者嘅，係啦，咁而過程裏面呢啲示威者咧，咁啊不停咁去叫囂啦，個別就仲有向我哋警察嘅同事咧就投擲一啲嘅硬物嘅，即係包括一啲磚塊啊同埋玻璃樽等等，係啦，咁亦都有個別的暴力人士咧就拍打我哋警車車身，咁所以喺當時我哋同事喺以寡敵眾嘅情況底下咧，係決定撤退嘅。咁啊當時扯戰扯退嘅時候，有啲同事就開始上警車啦，係啦。而喺你所講嘅嗰個畫面裏邊咧，係啦，我根據同事俾我資料咧，就係、是係有啲同事係一定係有啲同事先上車，有啲同事後上車，係啦。而嗰個畫面嘅同事咧，當時佢係面對前面其實係有一大班嘅示威者喺度，而佢當時所使用嘅胡椒噴劑咧，其實係應該係瞄向前面嘅一大班嘅暴力示威者嘅，係啦。而好似頭先阿謝常曾經有提及過啦，無可奈何地好多時喺我哋處理一啲暴力示威者嘅時候咧，係啦，就會中間就會夾雜住可能有唔同嘅人士啦，即係包括記者啦，係啦，咁所以我都喺度可能要再呼籲一次啦，就係、是、我諗我哋都唔希望有呢啲嘅情況發生嘅，係啦，咁但係即係我希望就係喺呢啲咁樣嘅兵荒馬亂、比較混亂嘅情況底下咧，就各方面都要顧及自己嘅安全啦，係啦，就盡量唔好就企喺警察同埋一啲嘅暴力示威者中間。而另外，我亦都想講出一點嘅就係、是。其實只是單憑一張相片啦，就冇曬啲前因後果，亦都冇一啲背景資料咧。咁其實咁亦都係唔能夠俾到大家對於嗰個情況作出一個評估嘅，係啦。而單憑一張相而去話緊我哋同事當時係咪笑咧？咁我會覺得我會話呢個只係當時一剎那捕捉到嘅樣子嚟嘅，係啦。咁啊冇曬啲前因後果，係啦。而我頭先亦都講咗，當時我哋同事前面係有大量嘅暴力示威者嘅。係啦，我諗唔會有人笑得出嘅，係啦。而當時我亦都講咗，我哋同事係準備撤退嘅，喺呢個以寡敵眾嘅情況底下，其實扯戰扯退嘅時候咧，其實我哋同事亦都係面對一個好大壓力嘅情況嘅，係啦。咁我相信呢一個畫面咧，係唔能夠反映當時嘅事實嘅全部嘅。咁我答案係咁多。
槍打中咗對記者，係咪誤傷咗對記者咧？或者係警方會唔會即係因此去道歉翻啦？同埋就係會唔會去追究翻即係開槍嗰個警員，即係揾得到嗰個警員，同埋即係如果揾到嘅話，其實會唔會追究翻呢個責任？會做一啲叫記者跟進。
我諗咁講啦，其實頭先我都講咗，我哋好主動咁介入咗瞭解嘅事件嘅。咁現階段我頭先都講喺嗰個而家我哋現有睇到一啲片段裏面咧，係聽到有一下聲響之後咧，嗰、那個女記者咧係跌低咗嘅。咁佢嘅傷勢，我哋今日其實咧都同領事館接觸過，希望接觸到佢同佢瞭解。咁現階段佢需要休養。咁佢亦都有經領事館同我哋講，佢會作出一個正式嘅投訴。咁所以我哋咧應該係會待個投訴開始嘅時候咧，會去睇翻佢嘅傷勢啦，佢會俾我哋嘅口供啦，去確認個事件嗰個原因。咁我頭先都講過啦，其實對於任何記者或者任何人士，如果喺一啲咁危險嘅地方，而工作期間呢而咁樣受傷呢，我哋都係表示非常之慰問嘅。咁對於佢嗰個傷嘅原因同埋將來嘅調查嘅結果呢，我諗現階段我就唔喺度作評論住啦。唔該。
好，再想問問啦，即係因為上次其實喺尖沙咀警署即係爆炸之類嗰個 case， 我其實就係因為事主可能未必睇到嘅資料，警方就去申請一個手令攞嘅資料。咁如果今次嘅呢個案件，如果即係記者可能都係未必想向警方去俾一啲資料，警方會唔會都
係
選擇去即係申請手
令
呢個方法處理？
咁現階段都未發展到呢個地步，我就唔去揣測佢嗰、那個佢將會做啲咩，而警方緊隨要做啲咩啦。因為我哋都已經好主動介入去了解事件咧，亦都同相關嘅領事館代表咧接觸。咁如佢所講，佢係會接觸警方作出投訴嘅。咁我諗我根據佢所講嘅呢一個講法咧，我哋會繼續同佢保持密切嘅聯繫。
好，最後兩題啦，前邊六三呢位，
係from the SMP Sub-China Morning Post。My first question is about allegations of undercover police, because as we can see that there are some, as you have said, undercover cops posing as protesters, and some video clips showing them gathering and throwing bricks.So I just want to confirm with you if that has happened according to your records and whether or not that is legal, because you have said repeatedly that there are mobs of protesters doing illegal things. So are they actually acting just like protesters? And also, will that actually incite more clashes with protesters? Because when you send a large group of undercover cops to an area, and if they have been found out, rather than calming the temperature, would that actually lead to more violence, as you have said?Second question about a doctor working at the A&E department of Queen Mary Hospital. I'm sure you're aware of that media reports. Why was he arrested and when he is found to have saline solution at the scene? And my last question relates to your categorization of terrorism, because I'm just wondering if you will be sending a very conflicted signal to the businesses and also tourists and other people in the city, because on one hand you are saying that the threat level remains at moderate, but on the other hand you are saying that we are getting closer and closer to terrorism. So how can you reassure people in the city that this is still a safe place to live and come to? Thank you.
First, I'd like Mr. Lee to answer the first question, followed by Mr. Kwong on the second one.
We have you asked about the we like to use the term of disguise officers rather than the undercover or another things, because in our police term they have the different meanings, you know. So the operation we refer to, I think, is disguise operations. The function for the disguise officers is as I mentioned before, is for multi-purpose.Is say for example to make a arrest in a safe distance, or maybe do some very close observation. The way to do is just to dress the light, the weight of the behave, the dress the light behave the target persons. Just is a very fundamental. It's not a new thing for police. The only concern is whether we can be to make it more effectively. So we. The thing we do is just disguise the way I mentioned before, and the second is deploy the suitable number of the disguise officers. And for you mentioned about whether we can stir up some of the things, because we have very stringent guidelines for all the operative participating in this kind of operation. They will not participate in any crime. They will not incite to do any crimes. The only thing is to do is just to make arrests and make the observation. That's all. So I don't think that that will be stir up the situation if you know we deploy this kind of operation on the grounds. For the second part of the question about the one of the medical officers arrest as seen, for this kind of operation, indeed for all the operation, for all the arrests, regardless of the agendas, the age or the occupation, we just based on the criminality, just through the criminal act, the officers observed. So I don't think that we can single out that this is a target, particular kind of medical officers or occupation for this one. So that's my part. Maybe Mr. Kwong.
Mr. Kwong, for the second one.
Yeah, I'll answer the second part of the question. First of all, I have to make it very clear that we made arrests based on the evidence and the circumstances surrounded the situation, but not their occupation. According to the information in hand, I understand that at around 5 p.m. yesterday, the police had conducted a dispersal operation in the area of Central and Admiralty, during which we arrested a male, and at that time, he's holding a hiking stick and without any clothing that could show that he is any kind of voluntary medic staff, etc. So at this stage, we are still investigating this case, and I understand that he is still under our detention for investigation, and that's it I could provide.
For the third question, I think I must make clear that I did not think that it's closer and closer. What I mean is that the violent acts are one step closer to the acts of terrorism. And as I mentioned earlier, that the Hong Kong terrorist level, threat level, remains at moderate. But the latest development of the situation or extreme violence that happened in Hong Kong nowadays is indeed very worrying. And police will continue to collect intelligence and liaise with different stakeholders, including the relevant government units, to assess the level of threat. And basically, counterterrorism has always been one of the commissioner's police operational priorities. And we are always vigilant of the latest intelligence concerning terrorism, and take appropriate actions to ensure that, to enhance that, the alertness of the members of the force can deal with the all kind of civil incidents. And I think that's what I can answer.
最後一題，立場。
立場新聞，想問一下三條問題。第一問題咧，就想請教翻咧警方使用武力嗰個嘅準則，因為咧喺星期六同星期日啦，都係有記者咧，就包括我自己嘅兩度啦，都係俾警方咧近距，就係可以遠距離嘅。但係警方嘅胡椒噴劑就向天發射，咁咧就我哋就不幸中招。我哋已經即係遵守咗警方叫我哋行遠啲啦，但同你嘅同事咧。嘅胡椒噴劑就向天發射，咁我哋依然都好多嘅行家就中，同埋咧就有啲警員咧係追住啲行家嚟噴嘅，唔知點解，即係呢個係有相違證，咁啊希望警方解釋啦。另外咧就係嗰個水炮車咧，亦都係咧係幾次嘅，即係上個星期嘅喺中環嘅政府總部外邊啦，今次都係啦，都係喺明顯有著反光衣嘅行家咧，都係中咗。即係好新鮮時足地咧，中咗呢啲水先嘅。咁其實係操控車嘅警員係睇唔清楚嗰啲係著咗反光衣嘅記者啊，定係有其他原因係射記者先？呢個第一個問題。第二個問題咧就係頭先阿謝 Sir 咧就強調啦，即係警方係有能力去處理而家個局面啦。但我諗好多喺前線嘅行家同埋觀眾咧、市民喺個電視機度見到咧，你哋嘅上級咧係指揮唔到下級嘅，即係頭先我哋見嘅嗰個打中記者嘅個案如是啦。你嘅同事已經拉走咗個同事嘅 咁但係佢都依然係開咗槍啦。另外喺呢、這個社會胡椒噴霧嘅過程裏面咧，你哋嘅同事已經叫同事上車啦，叫同事唔需要再去舉槍啦，唔需要再舉胡椒噴霧啦。但係你嘅同事依然都係照舉胡椒噴霧，依然係見到前面嘅記者依然係照射。咁我想問一下誰，其實警方嗰個嘅指揮層級係咪有喺今次呢個行動裏面有一啲再轉變？唔該。
嗰個武力使用咧，我一陣間會邀請阿方 Sir 作答嘅。但係即係呢位記者咧，其實頭先你講嘅嗰啲片段咧，其實好多都喺我哋嗰、那個即係見到嘅畫面或者嗰啲網上嘅片段裏面咧，就冇咁仔細。咁我相信最大可能就係你全部都喺現場。咁我好希望咧，你能夠喺即係日後咧，如果你想即係就住呢個事件想有我哋跟進嘅時候咧，能夠可以提供一啲資料俾我哋作出跟進啦。咁啊，我諗我只可以回應頭先就係喺第二個情況講話撳低支槍再上去嗰個咧，其實我嗰個有睇到相關嘅片段。咁頭先喺我之前嘅作答裡面都好清楚解釋過，其實咧當刻咧係有記者咧企咗喺一啲暴徒同埋警察中間嘅。咁喺我哋後退嘅時候咧，其實係有一啲硬物掟咗過嚟，而到我哋落到橋底之後咧，亦都有兩個汽油彈咧係掟咗過嚟。咁所以你話嗰刻只係得記者冇其他人咧，我就唔肯定我哋係咪講緊同一個事件。咁就住 ，sorry 我答埋先。咁就住其他一啲你提及過嘅情況咧，即係我諗同頭先我哋無論阿江 Sir 或者方 Sir 嘅解釋咧，都有即係少少唔同嘅情況，所以我好希望你能夠喺即係嗰個我哋調查嘅過程裡面咧，能夠俾啲資料我哋咧，令到我哋嗰個調查更加全面。咁或者喺嗰個武力使用整體嗰個原則嗰度，或者交俾阿方 Sir 唔該。
好，唔該阿 Sir。咁啊，頭先記者都提及到咧，就係話現場採訪嘅時候咧，有即係中咗呢一個胡椒噴劑。與此同時咧，喺可能喺另一個場景度咧，亦都即係我哋人群管理特別用途車噴水嘅時候，即係用水作驅散嘅時候咧，都中咗。咁我不如咧就其實我哋兩者個使用武力原則咧係相同嘅。咁啊，首先嚟講，第一個咧，我必須要即係強調啊，亦都指出咧，我哋咧係絕對咧並不會咧係刻意咧就瞄準記者去不論是使用這個胡椒噴劑或者我們的人群管理特別用途車噴水的時候都是並不會刻意去指向記者的。但是大家都希望就宏觀一點去看這件事，例如在昨天在金鐘這個環境，剛才都提及到那個暴力的狀況、那個、情況是怎樣，我都不再重複了。其實就是說我們是有需要去作出驅散，在作出驅散的同時在一個混亂的情況底下，確實可能記者是會跟一些暴力示威者的距離是非常之近的，所以在我們的驅散過程當中，
我想等 Sir 答完先，因為方 Sir 錯誤你
隔了一條屏幕，我賴了我們已經記得很厚，是你的同事用胡椒噴劑向著鐵高角度這樣射，我們知道你們那射的指引 是射向那些施襲者的面部或者近的地方，所以我們已經記得很厚，但你用這個方法射的話，那我們就避不了了。那所以我的問題就來了，我就是想問你，你們的指引是不是說是射向那些施襲者，如果他們停止施襲你就停止發射，那為什麼會射向高的角度，而令我們客氣幾那麼厚的人都不射中呢？這樣
明白，我完全冇錯誤理解你嘅問題啊！我哋當其時咧，我相信我呢一個場景咧，我確實我睇唔到，我冇見過，咁我所以咧，我哋都不能夠話即係可以好我
諗
你等我講埋先，好嘛？
立場記者
係啊，等我講埋先。咁所以咧，就我唔能夠話好準確咁樣話俾你聽，究竟我哋當其時咧，我哋嘅警員同事究竟喺現場咧，佢所作出嘅判斷係啲乜嘢？咁但係如果總體嚟講，就係話我哋同事喺現場咧，決定使用武力或者透過乜嘢方式咧去使用胡椒噴劑啊，例如去。唯一的目的一定是進行驅散嘅，一定咧，你講得非常之啱，係對住施襲者嘅。咁究竟我哋頭先你所提出就係話向住天去用呢一個胡椒噴劑，咁我哋同事喺現場，如果認為呢一個方法咧係能夠有效咁樣去進行驅散嘅説話咧？這個是他們現場一個專業的判斷，但是究竟在一個怎樣的情況底下，現場採訪的記者是可以避免 中招啦，大家經常會用呢個字中招，就係、是、希望咧可以透過我哋現場我哋PPRB 嘅同事咧，會去協助大家。咁啊，就係話喺現場採訪嘅時候咧，希望可以留意自己的安全啦，同一啲暴力嘅示威者保持住一個更加多嘅距離。咁啊，其他嘅武力使用原則咧，我哋必須我哋警員同事係一定會遵守。好嘛，咁希望答到呢個問題。
我諗即係最後我簡單講咧，其實我哋一定係唔會針對住記者去截嘅。我諗喺過去一兩個星期裏面咧，其實傳媒聯絡隊嘅同事咧都企咗喺記者同埋我哋啲同事嘅中間咧。其實我哋啲同事都中咗好多次唔同嘅胡椒噴劑或者唔同嘅即係自己同事嘅衝擊。最大嘅原因我諗講過都好多次咧，就係其實。警務人員在過去呢幾個月，尤其是最近呢段時間咧，其實當佢哋喺處理嘅一啲暴亂嘅時候咧，其實佢唔係平日嘅執法工作。昨日喺橋上高嘅情況，佢係俾人掟緊汽油彈，俾人掟緊一啲硬物。其中一個汽油彈係爭啲掟中嘅同事，如果掟中佢係會着火，有機會死。咁所以即係大家要明白就係其實你哋嘅工作同警務人員嘅工作咧，都係其實係一個好危險嘅。環境下工作咧，其實大家去保護自己嘅人身安全咧係首要嘅，冇嘢比自己嘅生命緊要。咁所以即係我再次希望即係記者或者警務人員，我哋喺現場必須要即係留意自己嘅自身安全。咁盡量唔好企喺警務人員同埋一啲即係暴力示威者嘅中間，因為咧警方係唔能夠作出反應嘅時候咧去分辨示威者同埋。記者當企埋一齊嘅時候咧，唔可以去到某一個位就停，跟住去到某一個位又開始，咁係做唔到。咁所以即係再次奉勸大家啦，即係必須要為自己嘅安全去揾一個即係合理嘅距離同埋安全嘅地方。係咁多，唔該。
好，記者會員畢林，唔該曬。